As I have told you before, the graph plan planner performs two types of operations. The first is forward planning graph expansion, which is what we've looked at so far. And the second is a backward search through the planning graph. This backward search is what we're going to look at next, although I probably don't have to describe this to you. I could just say that this is a depth-first graph search, where the search nodes are subsets of nodes from the different layers. But for those of you who find that a little superficial, here comes the details. And here is an overview of the search procedure followed by graph plan. We start by searching backwards from the last proposition layer in our planning graph. Of course, this layer PK must contain all the goal propositions, and none of these goal propositions must be mutex. Otherwise, the planning graph cannot contain a solution plan. So this is where we start the search, and the remaining three steps describe how we proceed with the search from any proposition layer. So we assume that G are the current set of goal propositions that we're trying to achieve in a given proposition layer PJ. Initially, this is the last layer, but during the course of the algorithm, this will move backwards through the graph. And what we do to achieve these propositions in layer PJ is to look for a set of actions, PiJ, that are a subset of the actions in layer AJ. So that's the layer before PJ. And of course, the actions that we're looking for must together achieve all the conditions in G, and they must not be mutex. Then we can simply take the preconditions of all these actions as our new subgoal, the new propositions that we try to achieve in proposition layer PJ minus 1. And of course, the search ends when we've reached the layer P0. And here is an example of how this works in the planning graph we've seen before. We start with our original goal, consisting of two goal propositions, in the last proposition layer, which is P3 in this graph. And this layer does indeed contain the two goal propositions, and they are not mutex here. Then we have to choose a set of non-mutex actions in our action layer A3 that together achieve all the goals in proposition layer P3. And the positive effect links tell us what options we have here. And in this case, it's quite simple. We choose these two actions here. Then we can follow the precondition links to identify the subgoals in our proposition layer P2. And these are those four subgoals, as you can see here. So far, this corresponds to one iteration in our search algorithm. And now we can continue as before. We use the positive effect links to identify actions in the next action layer, which is A2. And we see here each of these propositions can be achieved by one action. But remember, this graph does not show the no-op operations that should be in this layer. I just left them out to save some space. So technically, there are two more ways of achieving these two propositions here, namely using the no-op operations, taking them straight from the preceding layer. And that's what we will do here. So from the actions shown here, we select those two, and we also take the two no-op operations to achieve our goal propositions in layer P2. Then we can use the precondition links to identify the next subgoal in layer P1. So these are the preconditions of all the actions we've chosen, including the no-op operations. Here, four subgoals. And that concludes the second iteration through our search. So now we proceed as before. We use the positive effect links to identify actions in action layer A1. And we can also use some no-op operations as shown here. But in addition to the no-op operations, we also need two of the actions listed here, namely those two. And again, we use the precondition links to identify those propositions in layer P0 that we need to be true. And in fact, as you can see here, all six of the propositions in layer P0 are required for this problem. So that means we have found a solution plan in our planning graph. And it is a layered plan consisting of those two actions in action layer 1, those two actions in action layer 2, and those two actions in action layer 3. That's the plan we have come up with, the plan we have found through backward search in our planning graph.